Hello, welcome back to DrummerConnection.com. And today it's time to take a look at Halftime Shuffle number 3, Workout Part 1. I really enjoy this one. We're going to expand even more on the ghost notes. For the first time now, we're going to actually put a ghost note on beat 3 where the backbeat hits, and it's going to really help. You'd be surprised. Just this one little tap really helps propel this groove forward. Let's take a look at what this thing looks like. So as we look at this, the first thing you'll notice is for beats 1, 2, and 4, the ghost note is the same. It's the tap of the middle triplet on the snare drum. Now we're going to add on beat 3, the last triplet of beat 3 tapped. And you can notice by looking at this that now for the first time, you're going to actually tap while you strike the hi-hat. Before, all of the ghost notes were slipping in between in all the spaces. Now it's going to actually hit with the hi-hat on that last triplet of beat 3. Dynamics, always important, very important, super important here, along with subdivision, accurately placing those notes, those middle triplets, right where they belong, and now the last triplet as well. So once the hands are nice and smooth, no rush, you notice I gave you 3 different demonstrations, picking up the tempo. Keep it slow if you need to. You want the hands on automatic pilot. When that happens, you can download the PDF off of drummerconnection.com/drumlessons. You'll be looking at 12 one-bar grooves. They're going to challenge you now to keep the hands nice and steady, just like we're practicing, and shift around playing simple patterns on the bass drum. Let's take a look now at number 1. The next one I'd like to give an example for is number 4. The next example I'd like to give is number 4. This one has you hit the kick drum on the last triplet of beat 3. This is where we just put our ghost note. So be careful not to let that ghost note with the left hand get any louder as you work on getting the kick drum playing that note. The next example, number 7, can get a little tricky because it does not hit the kick drum 1-1, so as you loop it, it can be a challenge. Remember to pay attention to the hand pattern, especially those ghost notes. Keep them nice and smooth. And finally today, let's take a look at PDF download rhythm number 12. So you notice on the PDF, these rhythms that you're downloading and playing on the kick drum are the basic ones that we first introduce. Mainly meaning there's just quarter notes, quarter note rest, or last triplets only, sort of mixed around in 12 different versions. The idea is always to go back to this easier introduction on the bass drum as we get busier with the hands. So with that being said, be sure and check back for halftime shuffle number 3, workout part 2. We're gonna expand our rhythms on the bass drum.